everybody, welcome to Game Devs Play Games, and today we're doing a single episode playthrough of...
Downwell!
Yeah! This is a game published by Devolver Digital and made by Mopin and two
Strachki.
Strachki. Well, I'll throw them up on the screen.
Yeah, we'll put them up there.
But yeah, this is... We played this game at BitBash 2015, and...
it was a blast.
Yeah, and I've been watching this game for quite a while, so when I got a chance to play it at BitBash, I was super, super excited about
it. It was super cool about this game. A lot of it was the setup. When you got to the place, they had like a little like box. It looked like an old school controller, and all it had was a joystick and then an A and B button, I think.
Yes. Nope. It was just a left and right button and a shoot button.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It wasn't even a joystick. That's right. Very cool setup. It was the first game that at least Chris and I played, and it was a blast. We got there before the line got crazy long for it.
Yeah, we lucked out. Intangible tried to play it and instead got caught behind someone that played the game slowly and carefully.
Yes, which of course is always going to get you farther, but it's way less fun.
Yeah, and when you're in a convention, or I guess you could say BitBash is sort of a convention.
Yeah, we'll call it a convention.
Or it's a festival.
A festival, yeah.
It kind of sucks when you're kind of hogging it. And it's more about getting exposure for the game and kind of giving a chance to let as many people check it out.
Right, but then all the gamers there, they're like, ooh, I want the high score.
Yeah, and to be fair, Nathan, or Intangible at one point, did, like, break down and go, I'm going to get the highest score
on... Intangible did pretty well.
He did. He got us on third place in the leaderboard.
Oh, for that one game? Not for Downwell, but for...
I don't even remember the name.
I'm going to have to find that and play that with him sometime because he was in the zone.
Yeah, I reached out to the developer of that and we're basically just waiting on them to wrap it up before we play
awesome.
On the show,
too. Nice, that'd be great. That'd be really great. Oh, I love the upgrades. What did they give us?
So, okay, we've got Gem High, I believe what it does is it increases our radius that we pull in gems.
Yeah, Gem High lasts for a long duration.
It might increase our damage. I'm not totally sure. Stomping on enemies causes a blast. This is one of my favorite because it steamrolls. You blow up a guy.
Oh, and it just starts blowing up other guys? Oh, that's so good.
And those guys don't blow up more guys. Like, it doesn't keep blowing up.
Oh, okay.
But it allows you to just kind of, like, blast through your levels.
Oh, that's good.
I'm probably going to start with this because I'm on the first stage, and honestly, it's better to get that discount.
Yeah, that's super
right away.
Cool. What's really interesting about this game is that the bonuses, at least when we checked it out, at BitBash, the bonuses changed every time.
Yes, and they are randomly selected.
Which makes the game just that much more interesting.
The other benefit of getting that discount is that the shops always appear at the beginning of the stage.
Yeah, that's super cool.
That's actually very, very important.
Were the shops there at BitBash?
Yes.
We missed them.
We weren't very good at finding them. Back at BitBash, we were also rushing through the levels so fast that we didn't even really explore the little side caverns.
No, yeah, Intangible later was like, hey, you guys like missed a big portion of the game. And we're like, oh, that's what those things did.
Yeah.
We assumed doom would ensue.
I think, yeah, right? It kind of looks like that.
Right.
But after you figure it out, right, it's a little time void where
everything
freezes. And that's super, super nice, too, because if there are gems that are off on the side, so gems will disappear after a while.
Yeah.
As long as I'm in a time bubble, doesn't matter. The gems will stay there.
Oh, that's super great. So you can pick up more stuff.
Yep.
That's nice.
It also will kill enemies if they hit the time void.
Yeah, that's kind of nice. And it looks like you could set up a better shot, too, if, like, an enemy was coming down at a weird angle.
It's a little hard to make that work, but it's definitely saved me a couple of times.
Right.
Also, I have a new weapon. I don't know if you noticed.
That's a mega blaster.
Laser is probably one of my favorite.
That makes a huge blast.
It basically can one-shot anything. Ooh. Or at least most things. The downside is that you don't get as many shots. I get 1, 2, 3, 4 shots.
Okay.
Right now. And you can kind of see that in the bar.
Yeah, in the bar. I like the bar. I love the simplicity of this game. Like, just the look.
Yeah,
it don't get too complicated, and so it makes for just a really fun play.
Okay, so longer stay of invincibility, gain 4 HP.
Ooh.
It sucks because this probably won't be here next time. I'm going to go with this because I've gotten to the final stage, and that's probably one of the single most useful things you can have is longer invincibility. So I'm gonna get more charge, and I can't afford those.
Yeah,
so I stock up on charge because it pretty much is important in the later levels when you kind of need to bounce around a lot more.
So now what does Gem High do again? Does that just get you...
Gem High, I think, just increases your, like, how the radius in which you'll, like, pull in gems.
Oh, okay. Because, I mean, obviously after you pull in so many gems, you get a Gem High. I was just wondering how long the Gem High lasts for.
It's not very long, but so long as you get a gem...
Oh, it keeps going.
Exactly.
Oh, very cool.
So it keeps you moving.
Now, if you end up in one of those time zones, will the Gem High also freeze?
Yes.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it's really nice.
That's really cool.
Something else that I don't really play to this style is you can rack up combos. Oh, I hate this one. But I'm going to get it because it'll get me a health. I hate the burst because... So most of the other guns in this game, if you just hold down the shoot button, it'll just keep shooting,
but with the burst it doesn't.
With the laser it doesn't either, but
it's so crazy powerful though that.
Right, in the laser, since it's a single shot, you don't feel like you would need to hold it. I don't know. It's a little more intuitive that you don't have to slam the key down every time.
You feel like with a burst, it kinda reminds you of like an automatic weapon. So you'd hope that you just hold it down and kind of spray and pray.
Woo! Oh. So definitely not my best run ever. This is also a game that definitely seems to penalize you if you do pass up a lot of enemies, because they will follow you. They stop following you at a certain point. But if you're not fast enough, it can be hard.
Bob said pooping gems at first.
Sucks in nearby gems. Getting gems causes a bullet to shoot up, which I'm actually a fan of. This one... Okay, so... This one shoots a bullet out of a block when you destroy a block. However, this destroys all other blocks that are adjacent to it, so it's just a hailstorm of bullets. Sounds nice, right? But
Does it hurt you as well?
No, it doesn't.
Okay.
But I have lost myself a platform many a time.
I see. So what do you want to do?
So I'm going to get this one.
That one seems like a fun one.
I mean, having a larger radius to suck in gems is kind of nice.
Right.
But... So now we're in the catacombs, I believe it's called.
Are you gonna up your health this time?
This is one that's really hard to get. You have to have, and the prices of all the shop items
keeps
increases.
Going up. I was about to say.
I'll just heal.
Just do it.
Yeah.
It sucks, but you gotta.
I like to stock up on charge because it's not essential, but dear God, does it make maneuvering a hell of a lot easier, especially if you accidentally destroy your platform or, you know, there's a lot of moments where you're just not sure if there's going to be any safe zone to land.
Yeah, I get you.
You kind of need to just, like, keep bouncing around until you find something. So at some point, you'll get to play this too.
That's all right.
Maybe I shouldn't have been the first one to play this just
because I would have been owned, like, within the first, like, level. And I would have missed all these fun things that we get to talk about right now.
That's true. Yeah, when this game first... Oh, shit. This guy always gets me.
Dude, I regret not getting another chance to play Downwell at Bit Bash. I really wanted to see what else I could have done.
I mean, you should still pick it up, in my opinion.
Oh, I think I will. I definitely will because it's not too graphically intense. My laptop can run it. I don't have the best laptop in the world.
That's fair.
But I appreciate games like these because they're always just a ton of fun. You can just pick it up. You can blow off, 20 minutes, an hour, whatever. And it's not, too crazy complicated. You're not like for me, if I'm playing like a really intense game, like let's say Fallout 4.
Right.
That's a super intense game. Sometimes I still want to play a game, but I'm just worn out from it. So I can pick up a game like this and just kind of dick around for a little bit, and it's a lot of fun to do.
And it doesn't really require a lot of, mental power?
No. I mean, it's just about kind of... And especially if you're playing fast enough. Now, granted, if you're going slower, it might take you... You're going to be more careful, but I like to run through things.
Yeah.
I'm not, a speed runner because I'm not good. But,
Ooh. Okay, I think I should start focusing on health.
Yeah, we've been kind of getting fucked.
Yeah, just because I haven't been...
I like that balloon.
So the balloon is really...
Was this the last bonus you just picked up?
Yeah, so... damn it. The balloon has a single function, and that's basically
an extra
when
health,
it.
Huh?
No, it's when an enemy hits it, it explodes.
Right, so basically it gives you an extra health in theory. Like, it saves you from losing a life.
Exactly. It prevents you from losing a life so long as the enemy is attacking you from above.
Oh! Yeah, that makes sense because it's like a balloon, so...
Yeah, exactly. And that... it's more helpful when you just miss an enemy on your way down.
I feel like it's like a ghastly up there. Now it's gone.
But... I try to avoid the balloon, because ideally, it helps you once, and that's kind
of... That's it. I mean, once you've used it, it's done.
I mean, you get it at the start of each level, but...
Which, I mean, it's nice. It's definitely a nice buffer to have, but it's not like it stays with you the whole level, unless you're that good.
Yeah. Something else we haven't talked about is the color scheme. Which,
oh, I love it.
So, if you haven't noticed, the enemies that are red... they will damage you as soon as you touch them. In fact, any of the red parts are damage points. So, like, even the ghosts, we know that we can kill them if we hit them on the white part.
Right.
Oof.
If we took the health earlier.
Yeah, right. And the if we hit them from below, that's the red part, and it's going to hurt us.
Right.
So it becomes really intuitive.
Drone. I love the drone.
You know, I like the drone, but it actually isn't as useful as I originally thought.
No, it was a fun one when it was first there. And beep, boop, hello, I'm a drone.
And the drone, by the way, for anyone watching, it basically is an automated... Well, it's a turret that floats aside, on, like, adjacent to you,
yeah.
And it gives you another gun. It's cool, pretty cool. This, the youth, gives you another upgrade to choose from.
Oh!
It's more useful early on, but I'm going to choose it because it also gives me health and the other upgrades. I didn't care as much about.
Oof.
Yeah.
I don't think we're going to make it past this one.
You know, you'd be surprised. Sometimes when you're doing really bad, you have streaks where you just, like, rock.
I feel like I would just be at this point that, like, because I'm not as apt of a gamer, I would just kind of, like, fly through this level. I'd be like, screw it. If I can go fast enough, maybe they won't hit me. And they'll chase me down.
It kind of works, though. And especially, the game sort of rewards you for that playstyle if you do it well, because you'll rack up combos for killing enemies without touching the ground, and it'll just give you free gems for that.
But then you might miss, like, these little gem holes here.
Right,
exactly. If you're going too fast. And does that all end up evening out, or is it better to do... I mean, I like how they give you the options. Like you said, you can combo and get a lot more gems, or... you play it a little safer, and you can get into those little gem holes and find a bunch of gems.
Yeah. At the end of the day, though, I think this game is one that relies more on skill than anything
speed,
else.
Yeah.
Well, speed sort of accounts for that, too. Like, you could consider that sort of a speedrunner approach.
I'm sure Felix 13 would...
he might love this game, actually.
Love to get his hands on this, yeah.
Damn it. What was I going to say? Oh, but really, the way I play it is I do everything for the long haul. So
oh, yeah.
I know what the final boss is like, and I generally err on the side of I need to stock up as much as possible before I get
how
to
many,
the boss.
How many rounds are there?
There are 4 worlds.
Wow,
so
not bad.
We just beat world 2.
Two.
So we're entering world 3, and there's 3 stages per world.
That's a pretty hefty game.
Yeah, it is, and each zone has its own set of mechanics, each set of enemies. So this one, World 3, is water.
What? You have to get out of there in a certain amount of time?
We have to make sure that we maintain our oxygen, so if we're not fast enough, we'll die.
I like how the guy's in a bubble, too. He's like, hey, I'm good.
He's like, whatever, guys. I'm good. I also really like that the turtles... Oh, damn it, already. The turtles come back in this level, but suddenly... they function totally different where they're moving around, and they actually become sort of your safety buffer. It's okay. Oh, Nopey, you gave me charge. You almost always give me health. These little squids are tough, too, because if you miss them, they bolt down and kind of act like a missile.
Oh, man.
Also, this coral is everywhere. This is usually what kills me the most in this stage. Oh, my oxygen is depleting. Oh, I'm not going to make it, guys. If you run out of oxygen, normally it just deals one damage to you, but because I was already down to one health, that was it for me. Right.
Sorry, my face is like, I was just like...
Bam. So I unlocked two
styles,
levels.
Right?
Styles are fun. Okay, so I didn't like any styles. Hopefully we'll get to some of them. My favorite is the boulder style, which rewards you, I think, for stomping on enemies. But you get less upgrades. Oh, no. What it is you get more health, but you get less upgrades every stage.
It's super cool.
So I'm going to pass this on to you.
All right, you ladies and gentlemen, ready to see some
but
expert
failing. Can change the palette.
Green.
If
I like the green. Let's make me puke color. I like it.
Or we could be blue.
Let's do blue.
All right.
Let's blue it up. All right, so I got A and D, and then I got... space.
So the palettes are actually really interesting, and I like the default palette for the game because it plays off of human, I guess psychology might be the right term, maybe the wrong term. My psychology friends are going to yell at me for this. But the way that the human brain interprets colors is totally different than one another.
Oh, yeah.
So, like, having a black background and having the danger things red is actually, that works really well with human psychology because we identify red as a dangerous thing and our eyes are immediately drawn more to that than anything else. And that's why a lot of, you know, marketing tactics usually revolve strong colors like that. Colors like blue tend to be more calming, so it actually becomes a lot easier to miss them.
Blue, no, come on. I'm trying to get used to it, like, I'm just not,
Yeah, you're not...
I'm just not used to keyboard playing very often.
Oh, that's fair.
Because I'm more of a console player,
We could try with the gamepad, too.
Oh, no, man, it's all right.
You know, honestly, I haven't tried this game with the gamepad yet, and I feel like it might not work as well.
It might be better.
Were you using one hand?
Yeah.
What's wrong with you?
I wasn't thinking. There's a lot of things wrong. But let's do Heart Balloon. We're early.
Are you sure? Oh, but Liftoff is so good.
All right, Spacebar will make me accept.
It would be Shift.
Oh, shit. Oh.
Shoot button is basically your action button. Liftoff might actually be my favorite power-up in this game.
Oh, my God. I am so dumb, Chris.
Well, as soon as you hit any platform, you're good. You immediately reload.
No, I'm just dumb. No, for a completely different reason.
What? Why?
I was hitting Spacebar.
Were you not shooting?
I was not. I was, though.
Oh, well, maybe Spacebar is, like, another... like
another shoot.
I mean...
why are those birds following me? Damn you birds!
They're bats, Tony.
Bats, whatever. They're all fucking me.
Ooh, but you got the laser. Too bad you have one health.
Dude, I'm doing so bad. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not a good gamer.
Ooh, do you want to take another round?
I'll take another round.
Arm spin style!
Oh, I'm totally taking arm spin style.
This one's pretty fun.
All right.
So go to style select.
Nope.
Or the surface. I mean, that works too.
So now can I not pick styles at this point?
I think it'll let you choose a style when you go down.
We'll find out.
There you go. So you only find gun modules. And
ooh,
this is
shops
in,
are
this,
rare.
This is in the caves.
Yeah.
So, you know how sometimes we find those, like, gem piles?
Yeah.
Those don't exist anymore. You only find gun mods. But this is nice because this means you'll get more health and more charge.
Well, let's give it a shot.
And it means you get to experience more guns. So,
you know what? We're just going to give it a shot. Guys, I'm a terrible gamer, but we're going to have fun.
And if you notice, if you let your guy just fall...
oh, sure.
Your arms... I believe your arms flail as you're falling. Oh, maybe not. They flail while you're running, at least.
I cannot fight those birds.
It's all about timing and maneuvering.
Oh, when you're running around, it's like, hi, oh, yeah, look at me. Oh, everything's crazy. Oh, I don't know what I'm doing. Watch me not get past level one, guys. When I did this at Bit Bash, I got to like level 3, so I don't know what's wrong.
It's because you're spamming, man. You got to time your shots.
Dude, timing is for people who know how to do things.
You know, in your defense, it does take a little bit getting used to the play style of the game. Wow, look at that. You just dodged
just
them
like,
left and
dude,
right.
I'm just... what now? What do I got?
I think the candle might do you good, buddy.
For a longer stay of invincibility went to... yeah, actually it would. That definitely would. Will there be a shop here? There probably won't be a shop here, right?
Shops are rare now, so probably not.
No. I missed the shop last time, too, so...
Well, to be fair, you don't have many gems, so...
Yeah,
not the
matter.
Most useful thing in the world.
That's what they say about me in everyday life.
Oh, totally.
I'm self-deprecating, in case you guys didn't know.
Hey, but you have the shotgun.
I think I died, though. Oh, yeah. My God.
So, I do really like the gun mods in this game. They all are very interesting in their own way.
I'm just awful at this. Here you go, Chris. I'm going to hand it back to you. Let's watch the master go.
I'm far from... I've still never beaten this game.
Me too.
It's hard. The final boss is ridiculous. You're basically going down a tunnel at a... what's it called? Auto-scroll.
Oh, okay.
And you have to keep moving on platforms, and if you go too fast, you're going to get hurt by, like, a monster's jaws.
Oh.
But if you're too slow, you get hit by the top jaw.
Have to maintain the right speed.
Yep, so you basically are fighting it as you're going down, but you have to maintain
your
speed.
That's super cool.
But platforms are scarce, so you have to also time things really well, too.
Oh.
Nobi is one of my favorite guns. It might be a little bit more difficult to use, but if you notice, it has one thing that none of the other guns have, and that's I can aim it.
Yeah.
I can change its angle of fire.
That's cool.
It's really crazy because you don't... It actually took me a while to notice that was even happening, like, to be totally honest.
Yeah, right?
But when you get good with it, it can prevent you from... Oh, boy. I have not reloaded. There we go. Okay. Wow. I don't know what just happened there. But yeah, I like Nopi. I think also if you get a gun mod and you have full health, I think it will increase your maximum health.
Oh!
I've only seen it happen once, so I'm not totally sure.
So what we got? We got knife and jetpack.
Hot casing is kind of fun. Your bullet casings deal damage to your enemies. Jetpack is fun because if you run out of bullets, you still can kind of fly around. And knife and fork, I love because you can gain health by eating the bodies of the guys
you
killed.
There
you
go.
But
survival style.
It's not one for one. It's I think it's probably every like 10 bodies you eat, you'll get a health.
Oh jeez.
So it takes a while, but if you're good at dodging, then it can save your life.
Oh, I'm not good at either of those things.
Boop. Yeah, well...
But see, here's the thing. I don't get discouraged by being bad at games. It just makes me want to keep playing them more.
That's important. Well, it also takes a well-designed game to make you feel that way, right?
Yeah, right. Well, then, and there's just something really fun about this game. It makes you want to keep on playing.
It's. I think it has everything to do with both, like, the fluid movement, right?
Yes.
The movement feels amazing. It's perfectly fine-tuned.
It looks like the camera turned
off. Oh, yeah, the camera turned off. We'll pause real second. Real quick. Okay, and we're back. And I accidentally took damage because I unpaused it. And, yeah, well.
His excuse.
Hey, man. I had to move the keyboard. We had to resync the camera.
Yeah, just things got messy.
Whatevs. I got 2 health. I'm good. We got this. Nom nom nom. I got 3 health.
Spoke too soon, man. Spoke too soon. Oh,
jeez.
Dude, see, here's the thing. You're doing way better than I would be doing right now, though. You know what I'd be doing right now? I'd be like, I'm running away. Hey, you found one of the rare ones.
Actually, that's true. We'll go ahead and do this. 1 charge and 1 health is a pretty good deal.
Yeah, better than just the 1 health.
Right?
Get them charges.
Yeah, boy. I feel like we started talking about something before the camera died. Ooh, shooting dead bodies. So this would be bad for me because I want to consume the dead bodies.
Yeah, you don't want them to.
Laser sight's kind of fun. It doesn't make a huge difference. I think laser sight is best with Nopi because
you're aiming your shots. Yeah.
Exactly. Oh boy, I want to kill this turtle. Turtles give you I think 2 of the large gems.
Oh yeah.
Huh. Damn.
Those birds, man. Those birds.
These bats.
Bats.
Wow, another shop. I can't afford anything, but, you know.
Hey, man, whatever. You found 2 shops that are supposed to be really
rare. Actually,
rare.
The shop was probably the worst thing to have happen to me, because had I found
you would have, like,
a weapon mod, it might have given me health. I remember what we were talking about. So I was saying this game, I think, is very fun because both with its simplicity and its fluid movement... Like,
nicely
movement
done.
Feel. it makes the game tremendously replayable.
Oh yeah,
in the randomization, right?
Yes. Nice. There you go.
Okay. If I don't make it past the caverns, at least I'll be disappointed.
I'm just happy to clear a level.
And like, it's the game, all things considered, is actually pretty short. Like,
yeah, no, really.
It doesn't have, you know, a ton of content. Like, at a certain point, like, we've seen all of the power-ups. We've seen at least most of them at this point.
Right.
Actually, we've probably seen at least 3/4 of them, right? Getting gem. Let's do this one. This one's pretty nice. And like, we've seen at least 3/4 of the levels. Oh, maybe there are 5 stages, but I think, or world 5, it only has 1 level.
And it's the boss.
And that's the boss, yeah. So we've seen most of the levels. So we've pretty much gotten a gist of like what the entire game is kind of like. Really, from there, it's just a matter of like unlocking palettes and styles.
You know what this music kind of reminds me of? This kind of reminds me when you're in Lavender. Is it Lavender Town? No, Saffron City.
I think you're thinking of Lavender Town.
Yeah, Lavender Town, where the Pokemon tower is. Yeah, where you find Marowak's mother and all that stuff.
Yeah, it's the creepy ghost town.
Yeah, the creepy ghost town. Yeah, exactly. And really, the ghosts that are chasing you kind of look a little like
Pokemon-ish.
Yeah, and then little black guys totally look like Ghastly. They totally look like a weird
They
Ghastly.
Do look like Ghastly.
The ghosts don't look as much like the Pokemon ghosts did in that game, but
yeah, I wonder if that's an intentional choice, because if it is, that's like,
that's really funny if it is.
Yeah, that's a pretty fun homage to
Yeah, right? And because the music just kind of reminds me of when you're in that tower. But then again, you know, creepy, ominous music kind of all starts to sound creepy and ominous.
That's fair. I really love the progression of the levels, too. Like, it goes from, you know, normal, like, deep well, right? Where you're seeing, like, frogs and stuff. Pretty much anything you'd expect to be down in a well.
Yeah, right.
To, oh, damn, I thought I was on spiky
ground.
To dead
skeleton dudes.
To this creepy caverns at the bottom of the well. Nice, nom nom nom! And then we go, you know, deep into the water, the well, so it's obviously...
Oh, yeah, we're not in the water part yet.
And then beyond that, it gets crazier. We go into a void... You gotta be kidding me. We go into sort of, like, a void.
Yeah, right.
And from there, horrible monsters.
Just horrible.
Horrible. But I wonder if there's some sort of, like, deeper story to it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, you know, what if we're actually some, like, dead kid that fell in a well?
Oh my god.
I think the plot is that we're a young boy with gun boots and we're exploring, you know, the well. But what if I died down there and it's my, like, spirit searching,
for
my body? I think that probably would come across right if I ever beat the game.
Right, yes.
And that's kind of its own reward, right, in itself.
Yeah, just find out what's going on.
And, like, you know, honestly, if I can get better at this game and we can actually do a full playthrough to the end, because I really am not expecting that I'll be able to get to the end.
And
so sorry,
you know,
sorry, everybody, if you were hoping for that.
As
but
awesome as I am at this game, I don't think I can even reach the end.
But we'll at least play through this one last run, so
yeah, maybe we'll
nice
get intangible next time. He might be able to get through pretty far.
Yeah, actually, he's really good at these games.
Yeah, he's very good at these games.
So these guys, you can kill them without
I don't remember the skull guy last time.
He definitely happened. I generally killed them fast enough to where we didn't get a chance to talk about them.
Oh, okay.
But they're really cool because, yeah, if you shoot them, you set them into, like, a berserk mode. But you can just, like, stomp on them and kill them immediately.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah. Yeah,
I
like
love
the enemies.
The variation on the enemies are great, you know? It's like, this is just a really, just a fun and cool game.
It makes me wonder what the original concept.
Yeah, right?
Or where the original concept even started.
Mm-hmm, that would be very, very interesting to know.
Because I could see this being like, hey, this is a Game Jam game.
Oh yeah, right?
Do the drone. Yeah, right? Like, it's so, like, arcade in style that it could have started as a Game Jam game and the devs were like, let's
keep doing this.
Let's make a bigger thing out of this. Oh, one thing I haven't talked about, which I really should have, And I apologize to my sound guy for not bringing this up, but the sound effects are perfect.
Mm-hmm. They're very good.
We have the volume down pretty low, so I don't know how well you can hear it, Tony, but it's very, like, retro, like, 8-bit kind of like what's like heavily compressed sounds.
Well, and that's why like when we're talking, that's why I said this reminded me of the tower in.
Oh, that's right, because you can hear the music.
Right, hear the music. Yeah, I can hear the guns. I can't really hear the enemies if there's any noise that they're making.
Most of the enemies don't make sounds, but this guy.
Oh yeah, I heard that. That was cool.
He makes such an awesome scream when you kill
him.
That
was super cool.
And especially since his body kind of is like this broken open skull that falls to the ground. It's like, oh, it's just satisfying.
That's super cool.
Shit.
You got it. Oh, you got bones flying everywhere. Ooh, you got this. You're doing well. Don't take. Oh, you said it, man. That's it.
I don't believe in your
Superstitions. Yeah, well, you know, you're in a cave full of dead things. Maybe superstitions are real, man.
All right, the drone has definitely saved me already.
Yeah. You're like, oh, we should like replay the moment. Like, oh, the drone's not that good.
It actually isn't as useful as I originally thought.
And be like, oh, hey, look at that drone saving your ass right now, huh?
So much, man. The Om Nom Nom and the drone.
Yeah, the
seriously.
Om Nom Nom. Yeah, right.
They have been a great combo.
I thought you already got the candle. Oh no, you didn't use the candle before.
I passed it up for the. I think the bullet gems.
Oh, that's so cool how they made the water red when you chose the blue style.
I never noticed that before.
That is so interesting.
It makes perfect sense, though.
Because they want to use whatever's opposite on the color wheel or whatever.
That's not opposite, but it's
compliment.
Right, they kind of like swapped it around, right? Because originally the water was blue.
Blue, yeah, right.
On the normal color scheme. Now they've swapped positions.
That is so cool.
Yeah, I really like their color choices.
Dude, the nuances with the colors, man. Like, they don't really... Like, you don't need a game that's always, like, the perfect graphic game, you know? You have these cool, like, 8-bit styled...
Well, like, it's not, you know, high-resolution, crazy, realistic graphics.
No, it doesn't have to be.
But it's highly stylized and intelligently made.
And just noticing these little things, you appreciate them. And I wonder if it would change at all if you chose the green. Would it still be blue water, or would it be, like, a yellow water?
Yeah,
or,
right.
You know, it makes me want to try all the different color styles out or other backgrounds out just to...
And it's interesting, too, because there are definitely some color schemes that are... engineered to make the game more difficult.
Oh, I'm sure.
There's no way they when they made it, they were like, oh, this is probably easier. let's see. Getting gems, recharges, gun boosts. This is...
Ooh.
Yeah. No, this is essential for beating the game, I think.
Dude, you're doing really well, by the way. Like, I know
I'm doing better than
now
my
we're talking
first
about
run.
Superstitions. Ah, screw the superstitions.
But this kind of goes back to what I was saying before, right? Like, this run started pretty bad. And I was saying, like, it can turn around really, really fast.
Right.
And, I mean, this run has been a pretty good example of that. I really hope I can make it to World 4. That's really what I'm hoping for.
We're on World 2 right now, right?
We're on World 3. So if I can make it that far, I will consider this playthrough a success. Because World 4 is insane.
Dude, I already consider this a success just because it's such a... We get to explore more than we got to explore at Bit Bash. Like, for me, I know you have the game and you've gotten to explore a lot of this. But in Bit Bash, like, you know, there's never going to be a chance for someone to get this far. Or maybe there is. I don't know.
You don't really have the time to, like, build
Unless
up the
you're being
skill
a jerk.
Set. If you're, like, basically looping around in the line over and over again. But this game is still great to showcase at a festival because it's such a quick play.
Oh, yeah.
And, I mean, it's so well styled, too, and especially with the three-button control scheme that they had set up.
The simplicity... Like the simplicity of the game itself really lent them to stylize it in such a unique way.
Yes. Okay. I don't like any of these. I think I'll do this one.
Which one's that?
The Time Void might actually be helpful for the final boss.
But the Time Void
kind
of sounded cool.
It's not useful, in my opinion, during your actual run because you're moving around so much.
True.
That you pretty much pass up the Time Void and then it stops being useful. Maybe that's just because it doesn't fit my playstyle, right?
So, right. Maybe for someone else, I think that's the one tool you need.
Yeah, I do think, if anything, it might be one of those upgrades that's purely beneficial for the final boss. And honestly, I don't think that's bad to have.
No, not at all. Ooh. Well, it's the case that the candle is so important for the final boss, you know? And like you're playing the long game, which is so much better. Some people might not be thinking about the long game because, A, they haven't gotten that far.
Right, exactly. Yeah, if you haven't seen the boss, then it's like, well, how do you know?
Yeah, then you're like, oh, I'm just going to pick up this other stuff. You know, like, what just happened? How did that happen? Yeah, did the squids get you?
They must have. I didn't see it. Maybe it's because it was blue and my eye wasn't drawn to them. All right, it's been a while. Oh, yes. Boom. Oh, I can afford so much. Yeah, I don't really need more charge. Oh, I'm in a good spot right now.
There you go, dude. 6 health. We're looking fancy free and sexy. Well, you're almost in a good spot, except you don't have much air.
Woo! Well, oh, geez. I thought your air refills after you take the damage. Well, that wasn't so bad. I only took 1 damage from it. All right! Stage 4!
All right, Stage 4. I don't know how excited it's going to be, but Chris seems really pumped, so I'm pumped.
All right, this is where shit gets crazy. This is where, like, your gun boots recharge from,
Limbo! That's cool.
See what I mean, though, about
now how... I can see why you're thinking, is he looking for his body, or, oh my god, did you just lose, like, 2 health?
Yeah, well, the way you survive this is basically you have to shoot the, those things.
What's the other thing that you missed?
It might have just been like a thing. But yeah, you have to shoot these, collect the gems, and then bounce on the debris in order to recharge your gun boots.
What?
It's tough, man. That's okay. And it only gets tougher from here, too. And now my Om Nom Nom ability doesn't, I can't use it anymore.
Right.
There's no more bodies to consume. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Oh.
Nicely done. That drone might be helping you out a lot right now, dude.
Yeah. Actually, I think you're right. Also, if you notice, I've racked up a 28-point combo. So now,
that's what you need.
Wow,
there
the
you
time
go.
Void keeps the combo going. That's actually really nice. Nice. This is the point where you get like, you start getting shaky, because it's like, oh man, this is crazy, this is intense.
This is so good. Oh, yeah! Let's get quick high five. Yes!
Yes!
Keep going.
Okay. All right,
so what do we need? What do
don't
we
want
need?
That. Shooting dead bodies.
Killing
me. Okay, well, I guess this is what it's going to be. So now I can shoot gun modules to change it once to hopefully get something better.
Oh, there's platforms again.
Look at that. Oh! Combos can give you more health? Holy shit, I didn't know that. I've never gotten a combo that high.
Oh, see, look at these things we're learning by doing the whirly arm version. Oh, yeah, you got it, boy.
Whew.
Look at that, man, this is so cool. I just really like the layers to the levels.
Yeah,
this is really well done.
I think the pacing, too, is actually really well
Yeah,
done.
You know, because...
You don't spend too long in any
No,
level.
In anything. So you don't get sick of being like, oh, I have to be underwater for another level. And look how, like, crazy it got that last moment when you were underwater taking some damage.
Right?
You were like, oh, man. It's like, oh, I'm doing so well. It's like, Chris, you're almost out of air. You're like, oh, shit, that's not good. Oh, not bad, though. Come on.
I might be... Ooh. Oh. I might be able to get another health from getting a combo. Come on.
Oh, come on, baby. Come on.
Yes. Well, I at least got the 30.
Woo! Is your shotgun any good?
Oh, I actually really like the shotgun. All right, we're just going to let you pass along.
There you go. See, that's using those time...
Time voids.
Time voids to your advantage.
Oh, we might get to see the boss, everybody.
What?
I just have one more stage. Okay.
Heart balloon?
Yeah, fuck it. It's gonna be useful
for
this.
It's gonna give you another. I'm surprised we haven't gotten a heart balloon before.
I still try to avoid it because I don't think it's the most useful.
No, but it could be that one thing that just saves you.
Yes, exactly. Although it did. Oh my god, how did I dodge that? I already used it, but I guess it might have prevented me from losing more.
Dude, that is dangerous.
Come on, I got this. Triple shot's good. Didn't give me health though, which is kind of disappointing.
Which is sad.
Shit. It's okay. It's okay.
No, dude, we're good. We're good. We're still going. We got to stage four, man.
Oh, that's something else I haven't talked about, but you could wall jump.
Oh, yeah?
It's kind of difficult to pull off, and...
Come on!
Oh, you're not giving me... I have so much charge right now. This is ridiculous.
Dude, we need some health.
Might have made a poor decision by not letting my combo resolve at that last time void. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I'll do it here.
Oh.
Shotgun? Yeah, shotgun's good. Ah, yes, thank you. Okay, I'm gonna let my combo resolve so I can get some health from it. I got at least one health out of
it. Dude, that's something. That can keep you in the game.
Yeah, I will take it.
Oh! June! Double high five, yes!
Okay, everybody.
Oh, man.
This, I honestly, I seriously did not expect to get this far.
I have to change my underpants. That's okay. How exciting this got.
Sucking nearby gems. Do I get the one health, or do I get sucking nearby gems and retain my gun boots?
Retain the gun boots? Ah.
I think I get the one health.
Yeah, now. I would just take it now, man. Whatever, this is the last stage. Right, this is it, right?
This is it. This is it, everybody. And I get one final stay at the shop. It's not going to be useful, though, because I'm not going to be able to...
No, you need to heal. Well, can you heal and then...
Nope. It's okay. It's okay. We still have 6 health, which is more than I generally have when I get here, so...
Ooh, is that the monster?
Yep.
This is so interesting! Oh my god!
Yep! This is what it is!
Oh my god! Holy hell!
And everything wants me dead!
So how do you know when you're winning?
I think you don't.
Okay, well that's fair.
Oh, I think it's either gonna be a matter of getting down far enough into the well. Oh, that's going to be the thing that keeps me alive, is getting more gun upgrades and getting health.
Yeah.
Dude,
that time void might have helped you out not having those,
See what I mean? I think the time void is, like, the thing that helps here.
Because then you could have gotten more things out of it, right? Because it makes a time void.
Well, it gives me a chance to kind of calm down.
Oh, my God. Okay, you're good, man. You're good, baby. Oh, no, you're not so good. Oh, come on. Oh, God, it's just so frightening.
Oh,
this would have been good for, like, a horror series, actually.
This basically is a horror game.
Yeah, when you think about it, like right now, this is freaky.
Also, if you notice, it's using enemies and stage obstacles from the earlier stages,
yeah.
Oh, God.
You can't resolve your health, right? Or your combos?
I don't have any combos right now. Oh boy. Ugh. Yeah. Jeez. Oh, and there
Dude,
it is.
Dude, that was a good run though. That was a good run.
Look at all the things we unlocked though.
Yeah, right?
Woo, baby. Well, everybody. This was down well.
That was down well.
I challenge you to beat it.
Dude.
And please share your story with us.
Yeah, comment about it. That was awesome.
And honestly, I'd love to hear what your guys' favorite combos or abilities or guns are.
I'm about to change my mind, man. This might be my favorite Bit Bash game.
Dude, hands down my favorite Bit Bash
like,
game.
Like, as great as Chambara was, Downwell just, oh my
It blows God. Everything out of the water.
It's just so good.
The level of polish, the gameplay is amazing.
Great sound, like listen to that. You hear the little crunching.
Yeah, amazing sound effects, amazing aesthetics. It's just, the developers did it. They knew exactly what they wanted,
yeah.
And they did, they fucking, like,
they
tunnel visioned their
yeah.
way to it, and it's a perfect example, I think, of what they were shooting for.
Oh, yeah. Great job.
I'd love to hear what the developers had in mind as their high concept for this, but...
Devolver done good.
Well, this wasn't... Devolver didn't make it. They published it.
But still, like, good on them for publishing...
Yeah, Devolver made a great choice in publishing this game, so...
That was amazing.
And this, I believe this is a Japanese-made game, too.
Yeah, I think so. When we're looking up the, one of the creators...
Yeah, so anyone that says that Japanese games are on the decline...
Yeah, try some Downwell.
Try some indie Japanese games, especially.
Yeah, it's so good.
So... I think that's all I've got.
Yeah, right?
Cool. Well, thank you everybody for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this. If you would like us to play some indie games in our future, or if you have any requests, rather, for future single episode playthroughs, please, please let us know, because we had a blast with this, and we'd love to hear what people wanna see. So, cool. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you guys in the archives.
Bye, guys. Dude, that was so cool! Oh my god!
I'm so fucking happy.
Dude, that was so cool! We got to see the final boss! That was so cool!